golden rice was developed by researchers Ingo Potrakis and Peter Beyer with a very specific goal in mind, to prevent vitamin A deficiency. Each year, that deficiency causes blindness in 500,000 people in developing countries. The researchers genetically engineered golden rice to provide increased levels of vitamin A. They inserted 3 different genes into the rice. 1 gene came from a daffodil, 2 came from other plants. The 3 genes, working together, reproduce the genetic pathway that controls the production of beta carotene, which, when eaten, turns into vitamin A. By eating the genetically engineered rice, malnourished children and adults would get the vitamin A needed to prevent blindness. Sounds like a prime use of the technology, right? Critics of genetic engineering in food production don't agree.
What if it turns out that that golden rice is actually cancer-causing, and that in 10 to 15 years, all of those people who have bad eyesight because they are vitamin A deficient now have liver cancer? We haven't done them any favor. And until we've ruled out the potential that we're going to give them liver cancer, or we're going to kill them by some poison, we're not doing them a favor and we shouldn't put it on the market.
Golden rice was developed to address a specific symptom within the larger problem of world hunger, a problem that experts agree will continue to grow. Right about now, the world population is about 6 billion. A study by the United Nations estimates we'll hit 9 billion by the year 2050. So how will we feed the world?
The world population, since I've started this sentence, has increased. The amount of land that's available to produce food is decreasing. What we have to do on this planet Earth is to produce more on each acre of land in order to meet the food needs of the 21st century. In my book, the only way we can do that without dramatically destroying land that is dedicated toward forests and rainforests and land that we love to look at is by applying biotechnology.
Biotech crops can be genetically engineered to deliver higher yields, to withstand drought, to grow in unusual conditions, or to pack more nutrition into every bite. All of those factors could be important with an exploding world population. But not everyone agrees that biotech is the best or only option to feed the world.
Even if we are wildly successful with producing tons of additional corn and soybeans, or other commodities as a result of genetic engineering, it's not going to feed the world. I mean, we are producing more corn and soybeans right now than the world can possibly consume, and we've got 840 million people who are malnourished on this planet. Hunger is caused by a very complex set of factors. It has to do with everything from local ecologies and local social systems, and fundamentally it boils down to the fact that people are not entitled to food. It isn't that there isn't enough food available, but they're not entitled to it for all of these complex social and ecological factors. And just producing more stuff isn't going to change that.
So how will we meet the growing demand for food around the world?
If we genetically engineer food, we would have enough food to feed pretty much everybody in the world.
In Africa, the problem is not how much food they have, it's getting the food there.
There is a possibility that something could go wrong, but a very slight possibility. But with taking that chance, we could probably later perfect it, and then if just by taking that chance, we could possibly solve, like you said, world hunger.
We need to spend money on setting it up over in there instead of bringing the food over to them, setting it up so that they can grow there.